Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd ayyuhal ahbabu fillah. Continue on in our study of Imam Muqbil Bin Hadi Al-Wadi'i Allah yirahmuhu, his treatise, Hadhihi Dawatana wa Aqidatana. We last were speaking about the importance of avoiding bid'ah and avoiding sectarianism, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to be one and to hold on to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kama qala Allah ta'ala fi kitabi al-kareem, wa'tasimu bihabli Allahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, and hold on, all of you, steadfast to the rope of Allah, and do not divide. And many ayats and many ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam illustrate this for us, the importance of holding on to the Quran and the Sunnah and the madhab of the Salaf of this Ummah. Then after that, Imam Muqbil said, rahmatullah alayhi, نرى دعوة الأخوان المسلمين غير قادرة وغير صالحة لإصلاح المجتمع إذ قد أصبحت دعوة سياسية لا روحية. Imam Muqbil, rahmatullah alayhi, said that we believe that the da'wah or call of Ikhwan al-Muslimin is unable to rectify and is not authentic or the way of rectification for society, and that it has become a call to politics, not to the spirit of Islam. Akhwana Muslimin Ahabati Fillah, being as brief as we can, as there are whole books written about Akhwana Muslimin and their history, but just to give us a very brief understanding of who Akhwana Muslimin is, Dawat Akhwana Muslimin, it began in Egypt, and it spread throughout the world, especially the Muslim world. And the one who began this da'wah was Hassan al-Banna. And he was a misguided individual who used to, as it is narrated, kana yarhalu إلى القبور ويرى تقريب بين السنة والشيعة وهو عاطل عن العلم ويحتفل بالمولد ويقول دعوتنا صوفية حركية سلفية فهو إمام من أئمة أهل البدع. حسن البنا was a misguided individual, and he used to go to the graves, meaning he had something from grave worship or this type of bid'ah, and possibly leading to shirkiyat and the major shirk, which takes a person out of the fold of Islam. And he used to believe and strive to bridge the gap between Ahl Sunnah and the Shia. And he was a man who had this desire, but he was devoid of knowledge, ignorant, and he used to celebrate the Prophet's birthday, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he used to say that our dawah, or our call, is Sufi, haraki, meaning like a type of full of activity and movement, Salafiyah. So he put all these together, these adjectives, which have very distinct meaning. And he was a imam from amongst the imams of Ahl Bidah. So he believed in trying to combine various, take bits and pieces from various types of dawah to be active politically, or especially with regards to social movements and so forth, and providing social welfare for the society, which is not a bad thing, of course. But he had tasawwuf with him. And likewise, he claimed Salafiyya as well, to try to bridge a gap. And so this is where you see that Ikhwan al-Muslimin, the asl of the dawah of Ikhwan al-Muslimin, is to try to bring all the Muslims under one dawah. All the Muslims, regardless of their creed, regardless of their methodology and understanding Islam and trying to actualize and practice Islam, bringing them all under one umbrella. Yes, Muslims are one body, but they unfortunately are also divided based upon their creed and based upon their methodology or minhaj. And this is what distinguishes the sects and sectarianism, sectarian groups from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, because we're ordered to follow the Jama'ah. And that's the ayat we mentioned, wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. We're ordered to hold on to the rope of Allah, which is the Quran and the Sunnah, the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and not to divide, but not to just say we're Muslim and practice anything. Some being of the persuasion of like Jama'at al-Takfir, like the Khawarij. Some being Shia, that might be in the fold of Islam, maybe like the Zaydiya or some groups like this. And some being from the Mu'tazila or Asha'ira or whatever, or Qadariya, from the various sects that have appeared throughout the history of Islam, that is not sufficient in practicing that ayat. That is not actualizing the meaning of that ayat that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has ordered us to. And it's not the manifestation of what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called us to. He called us to be from the Taifatul Mansura, the saved sect or the saved group. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La tazal taifatun min ummati dhaniina al-haq." There won't cease to be a group from my nation that's on the truth. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, افترقت اليهود على 72 فرقة وافترقت النصارى على 72 فرقة وستفترق هذه أمة على 73 فرقة كلها في النار الواحدة كنا من هي يا رسول الله قال من كان على مثلي وما كان عليه وصحابي. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the Jews will break into 71 sects, the Christians 72 sects, my Ummah into 73 sects. So he said the Ummah would break into sectarianism. And then he said all of them in the fire except one. All of those sects will be in the fire except one, meaning the Jews, the Christians, and those Muslims that have divided the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and went away from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the minhaj or the methodology of the Salaf of this Ummah. All of them in the fire except one. And then he was asked, who are they, Ya Rasulullah? He said, those who are upon what I'm upon and what my companions are upon. Meaning that we are ordered to follow the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ and the Sunnah of the rightly guided Khulafa Rashideen, as the Prophet ﷺ said in another hadith, عَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ وَسُنَّةُ الْخُلَفَ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَحْدِينَ, that it's upon you my Sunnah and the Sunnah of the rightly guided Khalifat, meaning Abu Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu majma'een. So it is not permissible to divide and to take aspects of Sufiya, aspects of the Harakiya, you know, those who are about Islamic movement and Islamic revolutionary movements and this political orientation, and then try to piece it together with the dawah to Ahl Sunnah. That doesn't work, and that's where a lot of individuals go astray, because it's difficult for many of the people to adhere to the minhaj of Ahl Sunnah. Perhaps their desires lead them to to believe that there's other shortcuts or that the da'wah to Ahl Sunnah is not going to be useful in this day and age or in this particular situation or what have you. Whatever reasons that causes people to go to Hizbiyah and causes them to compromise the principles of Ahl Sunnah, it happens. And this leads people astray. And that's why we should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. رَبَّنَا لَا تَزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ ذَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُونْكَ رَحْمَ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ. O our Lord, please don't let us become misguided after you have guided us. Verily, you are Al-Wahhab. So, we need the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to be on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. And there are so many ahadith that mention that. Dawah to Ikhwan al-Muslimin is a minhaj mubtadi'ah. And as we mentioned, it is spread. And you'll find that Ikhwan al-Muslimin, that they have al-wala wal-bara to their group, meaning that if you'll find usually that the people who they dislike the most is Ahl Sunnah, meaning Salafiyya. Because you find that the A'immata Salafiyya, that they tend to be the most critical of Ikhwan al-Muslimin, speaking very harsh against them and criticizing them, and speaking about how they have deviated from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how they can rectify themselves. And this, for someone who blindly follows a type of dawah or orientation in Islam, can be devastating. And if they make al-wala wal-bara, they make loving and hating based upon their principles that they've accepted and that they believe in firmly, then of course those people who espouse other than that and oppose them become their enemies. So this is why you find Ahl Sunnah and Ikhwan al-Muslimin having enmity between them. This is not to say that Ikhwan al-Muslimin are not Muslim. But what you'll find under Ikhwan al-Muslimin, under the umbrella, is you'll find every type of innovation. And some innovation, but depending on the particular individual, what they believe and what they're practicing, can be bid'ah mukaffara, the bid'ah that takes a person out of the fold of Islam. And predominantly, you'll find that Ikhwan al-Muslimin, as we mentioned, everything is under the umbrella, and that they give precedence to politics, to taking over the authority, to having control of the society, often either through political means, through voting and elections, and some sort of semi-democratic movement, that rather than looking to Sharia means and looking to rectifying the people in the society to make the changes that are necessary, they focus more on the aspects of gaining political power. That for them, the rectification comes from top down, meaning from the leadership down, instead of rectifying the people upward, which you see more in accordance with the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he gave tarbiyah to his sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. He educated them, strengthened them, helped them to strengthen themselves in iman before things like jihad were legislated, before the other aspects of the religion was even legislated, that they became strong in taqwa, strong in iman. And this is what reformed whole societies as they went forth and spread the da'wah of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. So this is what you find as the madhab and the minhaj of Ahl Sunnah, is that they believe in reforming the society based on calling the people back to Kitabi Allah wa Sunnah Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the understanding of the Salaf of this Ummah. And it's very important to add that, the understanding of the Salaf, because you'll find even the most extreme Sufi saying Kitab wa Sunnah. Even you'll find some Shia saying Kitab wa Sunnah. But what distinguishes these groups and these sects from one from another is the madhab of the Salaf, is how did the Sahaba, first and foremost, because they're the asl of the Jama'ah, how did they understand the religion? And along with that, I want to say one last fa'idah or benefit that I heard Sheikh Saleh Ali Sheikh, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, mention with regards to groups like Ikhwan al-Muslimin and Jama'at al-Tabliq. He mentioned this, which I found very beneficial and interesting. It gave a lot of insight and it shows his ilm and his basira and his fiqh. And he mentioned that Ikhwan al-Muslimin and Jama'at al-Tabliq, those groups are not sects. That there's a difference. Now, ulama, they may differ with regards to this point. But for me, what Sheikh Saleh Ali Sheikh said was it made sense and it was very daqiq, it was very precise. It had a lot of precision and accuracy in what he was saying. Because he said that they are not sects, but instead, rather, you might call them ahzab. You know, hizbiyya is a bit, in some senses, a bit different than sectarianism, and there's some ways you might be able to distinguish it, or Hizbiyyah might be more general. Wallahu tabarak wa ta'ala a'lam. But the point being is that those are groups because they don't necessarily, Ikhwan al-Muslimin and Jama'at al-Tabliq do not necessarily, as individuals, the people in those groups do not necessarily share 100% the same aqidah. That they don't have a particular aqidah related to that group. Although there may be some ways you can identify. A lot of times from Jama'at al-Tabliq, you'll find that they are Diobandi in orientation or in their creed, meaning Maturidiyya or Asha'ira. They're Ashari in their creed predominantly. However, you'll find they are more of a group or a movement which comprises of individuals with various creeds. So you'll find people from Ikhwan al-Muslimin that have mostly a Salafi creed. Mostly. As if they're from Ahl Sunnah, but they depart in some masail of takfir, or some masail of jihad, or some masail pertaining to leadership and politics. And likewise, you'll find even from Jama'at al-Tabliq, you'll find some individuals that, as Sheikh Muqbil said in one of his books, a very famous statement, I've remembered this for many years, where he said that you'll find from amongst them, and I think it's in his book, Makhraj al-Fitna, or Fitan, Makhraj al-Fitna, he mentioned that you'll find someone who's been going, making khuruj. He met people, or you'll find people making khuruj for 20 years. But their aqidah, they still worship the grave or they still commit shirk. Meaning they didn't reform their aqidah. Instead, because their jama'ah, their group, is not built upon ilm, seeking knowledge. But rather, they try to use the hadith, balagha anmi walau ayah, you know, relate something on me, even if it was just a verse or an ayat, they try to use that to say that whatever little bit of knowledge you have, make tabliq, go forward and do dawah. Now everyone has a role in doing dawah to the extent of their ability, to the extent of your ability. But that doesn't mean everyone is a da'i, that they should be going out and giving dawah and speaking about affairs and getting into issues that they have no knowledge of or little knowledge of. And so this is a characteristic that distinguishes that group, whereas the sects, as we mentioned, like the Asha'ira, Maturidiyya, the Mu'tazila, the Khawarij, the Qadariyya, the Murjiya, all of these generally are sects and they hold a particular creed. And this is why they have their names are derived and relevant to their aqidah. If you say someone is Ash'ari, you know almost automatically that they make ta'wil or they distort the meanings of some of the divine attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They believe in ta'wil of many sifat. And if you say someone is Qadariya, you know that they have issues with the Qadr. And these are issues of creed. Whereas if you say if someone is Ikhwani or from Ikhwan al-Muslimin as a group, that doesn't specify their Aqidah. Some of them are Ash'ari in Aqidah or creed. Some of them have aspects of the Khawarij in their Minhaj. Some of them have the creed basically of Ahl Sunnah, but then they deviate in some masail of creed and methodology because they go with Ikhwan al-Muslimin and they believe in that their madhab of doing things. So this is a way in which to discern groups like Ikhwan al-Muslimin and Jama'at al-Tabliq from the sects, the sectarianism that we found in the early sects and groups. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilm al-nafi, rizqan tayyiba, wa amal al-mutaqabbilin. And anything I said that was correct was from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.